three, two, one. Hey, dummy, your ship's over. Hello, I'm committing a crime here. Jeez, what happened to the other guy?
Man works 12-hour shifts, never moves a muscle. Not even a twitch.
Who is he?
I don't know. Some yachts in a hat.
We flew him in from the academy when you were hospitalized. Is it, how's it back? Bullet wound, wasn't it?
As good as new. Thank you kindly.
Ovitz.
Ovitz?
Yeah, it's a nickname. Hers. Respectfully and affectionately. Right, respectfully.
Superintendent Moffat, did he retire?
Promoted. Man's been 7 years in that office, doesn't make one valuable contribution. One day he slaps a Mountie hat on a Mickey Mouse doll and... Mm-hmm. She'll see you now. Won't be nervous.
I'm not.
Yeah. Well, not to worry, I'm sure it's nothing.
What is?
Your personnel files. She ordered them directly from Ottawa. But I'm sure that's standard procedure, right? I mean, you're the deputy, she's your new boss.
Of course, standard procedure.
Your medical files, your timesheets.
Also standard.
Sure. Wow, you sure have moved around a lot.
Excuse me,
Ovitz.
Ovitz. You know, if there's certain information that you've been privy to as part of your duties as the inspector's executive secretary, you have a responsibility to keep that information to yourself.
Wow. You'll be fine. She's already eaten 2 file clerks for breakfast.
I appreciate this, sir. I know you're busy, won't take a moment.
You're right. Disapproved.
And you thought this over carefully, sir?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for about 3 minutes.
Well, with all due respect, sir, 3 minutes for an officer wounded in the line of duty in defense of a fellow officer, I might add, seems to
be... The Mountie. Setting aside this penchant that you and Constable Fraser have for shooting each other, this bullet that you describe here in this form, this is your handwriting, I assume?
Oh, of course it is, sir.
It's a truly remarkable piece of ammunition. You see here it says shoulder wound?
Yes, sir. Ripped right into the old lateral deltoid, sir.
The truly startling thing? This bullet, once inside your shoulder, appears to have taken a radical change in direction, traveling southward, piercing a lung, and injuring several major organs. Now, what do you suppose it did that, Detective?
Who really knows why these things happen, sir? A freak accident.
Uh-huh. And a rather convenient one. Because this wound would entitle you to extended disability benefits to the tune of, a lot of sunshine and margaritas, huh?
Look, sir, I submitted the insurance form to the company. Now, if they approve it...
All right, then the insurance company and I might have to sit down and have a little chat. Because wound or no wound, you're back on the streets tomorrow.
And that's your final decision, sir?
Oh, it is. And Vecchio, this incident might fade from my mind completely were you to stay out of trouble for 24 hours.
Understood, sir.
Have a good day, Vecchio.
You too, sir.
Now, this bullet...
This magic bullet...
...entered here, took a sharp right, bounced off the collarbone, pierced the rib cage, and took a U-turn at the pancreas.
Stay out of my desk.
Temper.
All bills. Welcome back.
Any more good news, Elaine?
Your disability application? It's been denied. The insurance doctor said no man could sustain this kind of injury and live.
And the good news, Elaine?
It can wait.
Elaine.
They're burying you with full honors. Thursday, 3:00. Don't be late.
Thank you. that's the way that you'd rather be. Feel sorry for me in one way. You got to hurt me by telling me someday. So get it over me, baby, please stop leading me on.
Well, I'm a dead man, Fraser. Some yahoo down at City Hall reads my insurance report and flags my name in the central computer system. Look at this. Vecchio, Raymond, deceased. So then the City Hall computer instructs the federal and state computer to cancel my driver's registration, my driver's license, and my social security card. So now I'm being buried on Thursday and I can't even get my good suit out of the cleaner. Will you shut that off?
No, I'm driving. I should get to hear what I want.
This is my car, okay? You've merely been given temporary dispensation to drive it, which means you can keep your butt in that seat, your hands on the wheel, and the feet on the pedals, and that's it.
Oh, thank you, Your Eminence. I'll remember that the next time you need somebody to back up your phony insurance claim.
Phony insurance claim? Well, let me tell you something. I have latent muscle damage, which inhibits me from making three-point turns. Can you believe this? I've been putting up with this.
Why are you wearing that? Where's the brown uniform?
I just had my first interview with my new inspector.
Went well, did it?
I'm on probation, Ray. Inspector Thatcher has reviewed my job performance, and I gather she's found my methods somewhat unorthodox.
So this is how they punish Mounties in Canada? They make them dress like Americans?
Well, it's not exactly an American uniform. And the brown one was somewhat antiquated. I'm told that this is the current fashion.
I think it's kind of cute.
Thank you kindly, Francesca.
Look, you just keep your eyes on the road and you keep your eyes in your head.
I wish I had a uniform. You know, when you wear a uniform, you're somebody. People just respect you.
Let me tell you something, Frannie. You're my sister, all right? But trust me, no matter what you wear, people will never respect you. All right, pull over.
No.
I said pull over.
No. Not until you can show me some respect.
Look, this is my car, and I say pull over, now you pull over! Thank you.
You're quite welcome. Hey, 5 minutes, or I'm coming in after
you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. What is that, a dead animal? She can make you wear a dead animal on your head.
It's regulation.
Well, she's definitely punishing you.
She's my superior officer, Ray. I mean, she's not a field officer, mind you, but she's a very fine officer and a woman of considerable character.
Fraser, this woman hates you.
I believe so, yes.
Okay, police! Move aside! Police, move
Ray,
aside!
Ray, Ray, Ray.
Don't you start with me, okay? This is a legitimate emergency situation, all right?
What is, Ray? Bulls tickets?
Not just Bulls tickets. Bulls season's tickets. All right, police, move aside. Come on, back off, back off. Look out, buddy. Police, move aside.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I am going to cash my last disability check. I'm going to renew my pass, and then I'm going to have something to look forward to. Who says you can't take it with you?
I apologize on behalf of my friend.
In the alley, honey.
Thank you, sweetie. Have a nice day.
Evening. I will.
We're closing up.
Oh, no, you're not.
I'm terribly sorry. Bob, we'll just be a minute. Thank you.
Can I get a manager here? Can I see a manager?
I'm sorry, sir, but the bank is closed.
Oh, no, it is not. It is not closed. See, it is open.
No, it is not, sir.
Yes, it is, ma'am.
Ray, perhaps I could assist.
Fraser, look, this is my bank. This is my account. I'll handle it, okay?
Can I have a manager here?
Very good, Lori. Way to take the initiative.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, hi. My name is Raymond Vecchio. This is my bank, and this was my ATM card.
Ah, well, it's a machine, and occasionally we do have a problem or two. Let's take a look, shall we?
Yes, let's.
You've got 14 minutes to be in and out.
Vecchio, Raymond?
Yeah, how many times do I have to tell you?
Account number?
99105.
You do have a problem. The account's been frozen.
What?
It can't be accessed.
Yeah, well, I think it can.
I'm afraid not. Without a court order, detective, I can't help you. The owner of this account is deceased.
Deceased?
New team, huh, Vince?
Yeah, it's hard to find good help.
Okay, now let me get this straight. I'm here, my money's here, but the computer says that I'm not really here, so I can't have it.
I'm very sorry, sir. I'm gonna have to call head office, and if you could just come back tomorrow.
Hey, I'm a cop. I may not be alive tomorrow.
Well, according to this, you're not alive now.
Excuse me, Ray. Constable Benton Fraser, Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Sir, I am fully prepared to vouch for this man's veracity.
See, a Canadian is vouching for me. Canadians do not lie.
Well, no, I think that's probably
he
hyperbole.
Is also a Mountie. If you cannot trust a Mountie, who can you trust?
Again, Ray, I'm not sure I'd go so far as...
Oh, yes, you would.
I would.
10-3, Mr. Cooper.
Excuse me.
Excuse you? I'm trying to do some business here with you. Will you wait a second?
Look, Ray, perhaps
I want my money. All right, I'll tell you what. I'll give you this check. You give me $1,242, and we'll call the head office in the morning.
Mr. Vecchio, this is a secured area. If you'll just stand back, please.
Are you not going to give me a consideration here?
All right, fine. I mean, who am I, right? I'm just a cop, right? Nobody important. I'm just one of those nameless, faceless, working stiffs who risks his life to protect your business and your family, and then just happens to get his head blown off trying to find your stolen BMW.
Are you listening to me? Is anybody listening to me?
Ray, there's something we better
not
discuss.
Not now, Fraser.
Mr. Cooper, we have 5 minutes. Ray! So hold up.
Get down!
Let's not have any dead heroes.
Okay, everyone, nice and slow. Down on the floor. Down! You, the Mountie.
Friends of yours?
Ours. Last year, she robbed a brokerage firm.
The one who shot you in the hat?
Mm.
You made my life hell.
I'm terribly sorry.
Don't apologize to her.
Don't shoot. Please don't. Nobody's gonna shoot. Just get down. No! Open it. Open it.
I can't. It's got a time lock on it.
So disarm it.
I can't. No one can.
What time does it open?
8:00. Tomorrow morning.
He's not getting away with this! You hear that, Mountie?
It's okay, baby. It's okay. We'll take care of the Mountie.
I dreamed about him, Lenny, every night in prison. I carved his face into my cell wall with my fingernails!
Morgan, I got you out of there, didn't I? I'll get you out of this, okay?
Forget it! It's impossible! That door is solid steel, 2 feet thick!
Harold!
Combinations are easy enough. It's the time lock. There's no point in drilling a lock that can't be disabled.
Yeah, but there is a way, right?
There's always a way. You drill holes into the locking bolts, you stuff them with C4, and then you blow them.
Good. Pack it with the stuff. I want those bozos blown to kingdom come.
Hello, 911, hello! I am not receiving. Why aren't I receiving here?
We're in a vault, Ray.
I know we're in a vault.
High carbon steel, I'd say 8 to 10 inches thick. There's no hollow spots in the walls. It's probably backed by solid concrete.
All right, check for ventilation.
Got it.
Vent?
Yes. And we are in luck, Ray. It is completely sealed off.
What?
Airtight, obviously, for security. Rest easy, Ray. The money is perfectly safe.
Oh, well, that's a relief, because for a moment there, I was concerned that all these little Thomas Jeffersons were going to run out of oxygen.
Ray, there is no need for either sarcasm or panic. We are in an 8x10 room with a 10-foot ceiling. That gives us roughly 800 cubic feet of air. It is now 3:15, and the time lock is not due to open until 8 a.m., so there is no danger of us suffocating for at least... You know, Ray, in situations like this, the Inuit...
No, we're gonna die.
We are not gonna die.
Oh, yes, we are, Fraser. We're gonna die protecting somebody else's money.
Ray, there is an inherent danger in all police work.
No, Fraser, what there is an inherent danger working with you.
Well, you didn't have to do this. You could have thrown your hands in the air like a baby.
That's what I was trying to do. I am not a baby.
No, Ray, I know you. You were attempting to protect this institution and its employees with your life.
You see, that's where you get confused. I'm not like you, Fraser. I don't throw myself in the line of fire just so that some money-grubbing, backstabbing bank doesn't have to pay higher insurance premiums.
You don't really.
Oh, yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do, in my heart and soul.
I beg to...
Could you slow down a bit, Harold? I'm looking forward to relaxing in jail this weekend.
I gotta drill 8 holes through 12 inches of steel. Now, am I doing this for you?
I'm gonna go check on the truck. Why don't you put this on the door?
What, I'm messenger boy?
Go. No, Ma, I can't go to the butcher's because I'm busy. Ma, it's always what you need and what Ray needs. What about what I need sometime? What do I need? How about being treated like a valuable, respected human being for a change? No, Ma, the butcher does not respect me. Kiss me and I'll give you a pork round. Does not constitute respect. Ma, I gotta go. Yeah, okay, Ma, fine. Yeah, pork chops and veal. Yes, milk fed. Okay. You stay here. And don't touch the radio.
This is interesting, Ray. It's a 1986 Windsor Creighton Protector 2000.
Frazier, do you realize that we're going to die surrounded by millions of dollars?
Ray, do you realize that this door has 8 cantilever deadbolts countersunk into 2 feet of solid high-carbon steel? And in the 10 years this vault has been in active use, to my knowledge, it has never been breached.
I believe the Greeks have a word for this. Hubris.
Well, no, Ray. Actually, hubris is excessive pride or wanton insolence.
What about pathos?
Well, pathos is a quality in an artistic representation which excites a feeling of pity or sadness. Hmm.
What about onomatopoeia?
Well, onomatopoeia is wherein a word imitates the sound or action of the thing it describes, i.e. woof, bow wow, ribbit.
Irony.
Now, the deadbolts are roughly 4 inches in diameter. If they're drilling, it means they intend to fill the holes with some kind of high explosive and then blow the door off its hinges. No doubt they've already disabled the surveillance cameras, so there's no fear of the police showing up until the alarm has been triggered.
Which it won't be until the door is blown.
Which will be too late.
Which means we'll probably die.
Oh, we're not gonna die, Ray. No doubt some foot patrol will chance upon our unhappy scene and notice that something is amiss.
In Chicago.
That's a good point.
Francesca. Ah!
Hey! Open up in there! Don't hide from me, I see you!
We're closed!
What?
Read the sign, lady.
Hey, don't get smart with me, mister. Oh, what? So you're saying because I'm a woman, I must be overreacting?
Don't cause a scene, lady.
A scene? Oh, no, this is not a scene. Now, if I were screaming and stamping my feet, for instance, like this, yes, this would be making a scene. A guy with a bad haircut flashes a bag.
Some nut says we got her brother.
Look, you tell Mr. Fancy Pants Detective either he's out here in 2 minutes or I'm wrapping that car around a tree.
Detective, huh?
Okay, where is he?
talk. I refuse to be used as a pawn to make my brother forsake his duty.
If that door doesn't open in 10 seconds,
leave that.
Phone.
I was afraid of this. No, Ray, bring it!
No!
What are you doing? It is them.
Of course it's them. Who else has the phone number to the vault?
Ray, they are going to try to talk to us. Convince us to open the door.
We can open it?
Of course we can open it. The emergency release lever is right here. It's standard equipment.
You knew this and you didn't tell me?
Ray, would you please listen to me? This isn't about the loss of millions of dollars from some bank. This is about the average ordinary citizen who has placed their trust in an institution. We are here to guard that trust.
Frazier, they'll get their money back. It's insured.
It's broken. Not broken. I disabled it.
What did you do that for?
In case one of us weakened.
Look! What are you doing?
It was Francesca.
Of course it's Francesca. She's in the bank.
He hung up. I'm standing here with a gun to my head, and he won't even come to the phone.
They're gonna kill her, Frazier.
No, they're not, Ray. If they can't speak to you, then they can't tell you that they have Francesca. And if they can't tell you that they have Francesca, then they can't threaten you, rendering the point of a hostage moot.
But I know that they have her.
But they don't know that you know. You see, it's the only way to protect her.
She's my sister.
She's also a very intelligent young woman, capable of handling herself in any given situation.
Do you really believe that?
Not at all.
Oh, good, me neither.
Do something! Lady, I can't threaten him if he won't pick up the phone.
So keep dialing. What kind of bank robber are you?
Look, you either shut up and sit down or I'm gonna shoot you.
Yeah, like anyone would notice.
Don't just stand there, drill!
Out of here, get! Go on!
They're gonna kill us all, you know. A last prayer, a single bullet to the head. Tomorrow, we'll be nothing but headlines. Yes, headlines and photographs. Oh, dead bodies on a blood-soaked rug, family members prostrate with grief. A reporter chronicles their last brave moments. Oh, no, no, don't cry. Hey, let's sing a marching song.
Okay, so they have the drills, they have the explosives, and they have my sister, and we've got, what do we've got, Frazier?
We have our wits, Ray.
So they have the drills, they have the explosives, and they have my sister, and we've got, what do we have, Frazier?
Well, there's always Diefenbaker. He's ever alert to an emergency.
I said stay out of here. Get out!
In fact, I think he will go straight for the nearest available help.
Okay, so, they have the drills, they have the explosives, and they have my sister.
The first thing you have to watch out for is that Norwegian syndrome, because you cannot identify with them in any way. But not that you would, because you are brave, innocent hostages, and they're unfeeling worms who should be stripped naked and hung upside down by their toes, but that's later. Okay, in the meantime, I need you to listen to me very carefully.
Excuse me, who are you anyway?
I can't tell. I don't know how deep the deadbolt is. I need the specs for the door.
I don't have the specifications for the door, Ray. But I've been making calculations based on its thickness, the depth of the existing hole, and the reflection of the tonal input as it percusses against my tuning fork.
Where the hell did you get a tuning fork?
Well, that's not important, Ray. What is important is that I've managed to ascertain that the bolts are 8.3 inches from the outside surface.
How far?
About 8 inches.
We're there then. That's 19.1 minutes a bolt.
19.1 minutes per bolt to drill the remaining holes. Another 2 minutes after that to set the charges, and then another minute to prime them.
And 1 minute to prime them. That's...
Now that is 137 minutes in total. The upshot of this, Ray, is that we need a plan.
Well, there is a plan, Frazier. And it goes something like this. They drill a door, they blow the door, they shoot us with automatic weapons, and we die.
Mm-hmm.
What about a happier plan, Ray? A plan in which we surprise them, we disarm them, and we rescue the hostages.
And we do all this with a tuning fork? Look, Fraser, if I had a choice between one of their plans and one of yours, I'd choose theirs. It's probably safer.
Sure, we'll die painful, grisly deaths, but it'll be worth it. Because finally, our families will respect us.
You know, Ray, there's only one way to break out of here, rescue your sister, and prevent this robbery.
Yeah, how's that?
It'd be dangerous. You'd be risking your life. You'd have to trust me implicitly.
Yeah, well, I don't trust you at all.
You don't really mean that, do you?
Oh, yes, I do. I mean, why should I trust you? In the last 2 years, you've risked our lives 24 times.
Boy, I had no idea it'd been that many.
Yeah, well, it has.
I didn't realize you'd been counting.
Well, I just felt that I should because you didn't seem to pay any attention to it.
Well, I'm sorry if it upset you, Ray.
I am not upset. I just wish that you would ask me about it. Let me know in advance.
How far in advance?
Oh, I don't know, Fraser. How about an hour?
What if we're in the middle of a crisis?
Just ask me.
I'm asking you.
Well, I'll have to think about it.
Why?
Because I'll just have to think about it, okay? God, I'm trying to get some rest.
I know we've only known each other a brief time, but for some reason, I feel a deep kinship towards you and your cause. And, well, I know now that I wish to dedicate my life to whatever it is your life is dedicated to.
We're stealing money, lady.
Oh. Well, I suppose that'll do.
Okay, what is it? No, don't tell me, just do it, okay? Because if you tell me, two things are gonna happen. One, I'm gonna know it's stupid, and two, you're gonna do it anyway. This way, you can just do it, and I won't know that it's stupid.
So you've given this some thought?
Yes.
And you're quite sure?
Oh, I'm positive.
All right.
That you didn't want to know.
Yeah, well, now I want to know.
Well, I'm not sure that I should tell you.
Oh, tell me.
You're sure?
Yes.
All right. As I mentioned earlier, they have 137 minutes to open this vault. Now, they resumed drilling exactly 5 minutes and 27 seconds ago. That leaves them 131 minutes and 33 seconds. Now, taking into account the dimensions of this room, the size of the sprinkler head, and the rate of the flow of water, by the time they blow this door, this vault will be filled with water, and they will be met by a virtual tidal wave.
And where will we be in the meantime?
Floating.
I realize that, dead or alive.
Well, there should be sufficient airlift.
Well, how much is sufficient?
About an inch, give or take.
Oh, that much.
What?
That much.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is providing they maintain a constant rate of drilling.
Now or never. I'll beat us in. Hey! You at the drill! Take me.
And what if they stop drilling?
Right, so it was a desperate and foolish ploy. But someone has to stand up to you people. I'll sacrifice anything, you know. My life, my honor, even my body.
Look, I promise you, lady, nobody wants your body.
Well, you say that now, but later when you're tired and frustrated and the smell of sweat
is in the air.
Are you done yet?
Just shut up and stay put, please.
You should have had her tied up in the first place.
You see, now I have them exactly where I want them. They think I'm nuts.
You know, I just can't shake this feeling that we're gonna die. Fraser! How many was that?
Six. There's two more to go.
All right, we've lost 7 minutes. And at 0.26 cubic inches per second, that will leave us approximately... Well... You know, Ray, there are worse things than dying.
Yeah, name three.
How about two?
All right.
Living without honor or dying without reason?
Which one would this be?
Well, this wouldn't be either of those, actually. This would be more like death in the line of duty.
You know, I always thought duty was something you get paid to do. This is more like voluntary stupidity.
Well, I'm sure there are some people who think that's what good deeds are, right?
Well, aren't they?
Well, I don't know. I've never thought about it.
Trouble. Canadian. Lead on.
Get the detonator.
Fraser, you almost get yourself killed for some stupid cause every other day, and you never stop to ask yourself, what are you getting out of this? Is someone paying you to do this, or am I just some crazed do-gooder? Or is God telling you to do this?
Ray, that is private property.
I don't care. I am getting my $1,242, all right? That is what I'm getting out of this. But what about you? Do you know what you're getting out of this? No, you don't, do you?
No, Ray, it is simply a responsibility I assumed when I put on the uniform.
The uniform? You don't even like that uniform. They took away the uniform that you liked. And did you say anything? No, not a word.
We're done.
Blow it.
Think of me fondly.
Admit it, Fraser. You feel unappreciated. Can you do this for me? Can you do this one small thing for me? Can you admit that at least once in your perfect existence, you felt the need to put yourself before your duty? Because if you do that, I can float peacefully to my death.
Why, Ray?
I just will. Now humor me.
All right. Occasionally. That's only very occasionally. I do feel... Is this really necessary?
Fraser, I am drowning on dry land.
All right, Ray, all right. Occasionally, I do feel... What was it?
Unappreciated.
Occasionally, I do feel unappreciated.
You do?
Occasionally.
Well, thank you. Good. So, from now on, for the next minute or two, can you try to stick up for yourself a bit more?
Yes, I will try, Ray.
We're on.
Well, at least they won't be gathered for nothing on Thursday. Hey, Benny.
Yes, Ray?
My eulogy. I would have liked you to have delivered it.
Well, I'm honored, Ray.
What would you have said?
Well, let's see. I think I would have said that you were a good friend and that you never failed me.
I didn't, did I?
Never. Well, except for that one time.
What time?
You know, Ray, to discuss it in a situation like this really would be considered nitpicking.
How did I fail you?
You didn't really fail me. I've almost forgotten about it.
Well, 10 seconds ago, you didn't forget about it. You see, this is so like you. Here we are having a nice mano-a-mano, and you have to ruin it by being honest.
Our plan unfolding.
Good work, Ray.
And you, Fraser.
I thought I told you to stay in the car.
Oh, yeah, that's gratitude.
For what?
For 30 years of picking up socks, buying veal, and kissing butchers.
Excuse me?
And the next time I say 5 minutes, I mean 5 minutes. Clear?
See, Fraser, now this is how it's done. The criminals are inside and we are outside. Now, do you think you can remember that next time?
I'll try, Ray.
Thank you. Is that a smile?
No, of course not. Of course not. Although I will admit to a certain satisfaction.
It is a smile, well, I'll be.
Be what, Ray?
It's an expression.
It means nothing to me. With respect, ma'am, I have always considered myself to be a diligent officer who's conducted himself with loyalty and obedience. However, this uniform, I have worn this uniform with pride my entire career, as my father wore his many before him. To me, it is much more than just a piece of cloth. It is a tradition that links me to every officer who has ever worn it and acquitted himself with honor and integrity. while it is not the current fashion, I would be hard-pressed to change it without feeling that I had in some way betrayed that tradition. And so, in that this uniform, while not in common usage, is still regulation issue, and in that in most postings, the choice of uniform rests with the officer and not with the commander, well, I would prefer, well, that is, if it's all the same. Actually, I don't much care. Ma'am, I will not change my uniform.
You're fired.
Understood.
High winds, northern sky will carry you away. You know you have to leave here. You wish that you could stay. It's four directions on this map, but you're only going one.